We are naturally social beings. Society encourages your evolution and heeds you to not be alone. Sociability ensures survival, and it also makes you feel good. So it's no wonder that for some of us, the thought of being alone terrifies us. But as David White once said, sometimes it takes darkness and the sweet confinement of your aloneness to learn that anything or anyone that does not bring you alive is too small for you. Your aversion to solitude can be a result of stigma or a tumultuous childhood. For example, narcissistic parenting. Perhaps it's because you often conflate loneliness and solitude. Loneliness is a negative state marked by isolation, whereas solitude is being alone without feeling lonely. But regardless of the reason, having time alone can be beneficial. During this time, surely many of you have had to adapt to a life alone in your homes. At first, loneliness can seem terrifying and isolating, but solitude should not be feared. Many discoveries lie in wait when you take time to be alone. Here are 6 ways you can enjoy solitude. Number 1, self-reflect. Am I holding on to something that does not serve me? Am I living intentionally? Or what matters most to me in life? These are just some examples of the answers your solitude can fetch for you. Time alone affords you time for self-reflection and self-healing. In solitude, you can turn inwards and assess your needs and thoughts and find solutions to pressing problems. Solitude helps you achieve a degree of mental clarity that you might not have been aware that you needed. Number 2, find joy. How often have you had to make the choice between turning in early or pulling an all-nighter on a weekend? One way to make use of alone time is to find joy. Often we're bogged down by all the things that we have to do, and we push aside what we want to do. Finding joy can be taking some time to meditate on your thoughts and emotions, or doing something you actually want to do. In the process of exploration and discovery, be grateful for the solitude. It can include starting a happiness journal where you occasionally write down things that bring you joy. Number 3, nurture your hobbies. This is a perfect time to pick up the hobby you never seem to get time for, like watercoloring, or practice the piano like you've always yearned to. Having or taking some time to be alone allows you to explore or re-explore those things you were once interested in, but did not have time to do. Nurturing your hobbies not only increases your skill levels, but forces you to engage creatively in something, which in turn helps your brain's development. Number 4, take time for self-care. What is your ultimate go-to self-care? Have you sorted out your winter wardrobe yet? Self-care comes in many different packages. For some, it's a physical practice, soaking in a hot bath, painting your nails, or doing your hair. For others, it means disconnecting from social media, practicing yoga, or cleaning. It's important to take time for self-care. Engage in whatever form of self-care you need. Not only will it give you something to do, but it will instill within you a sense of calm. Number 5, learn something new. Is there a new language you've been wanting to learn forever? Perhaps a recipe you wanted to try but never had the time for? Solitude is a great opportunity to learn something new, whether you're learning a new language or a new skill. Productively engaging your mind for the sake of curiosity is a wonderful way to spend time alone. Learning something new will not only make you feel more confident in your abilities, but also help you create a buffer against stress. Recent research found that engaging in learning activities helped workers create a buffer from detrimental effects, such as negative emotions, unethical behavior, and burnout. And number 6, play, dance. As you get older, does it seem like you're slowly losing your childhood sense of wonder and excitement over things? Do you miss engaging in activity for the sake of activity? When was the last time you did something just for the sake of doing it? It's been a while, hasn't it? Play grounds you to the present. While being in the present, the past, the future, and all of their worries dissolve. There are many spiritual, emotional, and mental benefits to play. The most beneficial is how it reduces stress. As a full-fledged novice adult, play may seem like a waste of time. And even if you are intrigued by the idea, how would you even play? Well, one way is to develop and retain your sense of wonder. Get curious about even the simplest things. That is the essence of childhood. Solitude is not just a moment in time. It can also be a state that you go into to find answers about yourself and the world around you. There are many ways to find solitude. On a hike, in between the lines of poetry, or during meditation. Being alone does not have to be scary. It's a part of your journey back to your true self. It is worth the time. Investing in knowing yourself a bit better, an opportunity to nurture love, find joy, and get curious. We hope we were able to give you insight into some of the ways you can enjoy solitude. Do any of these describe your experiences? What are some other ways that you enjoy your solitude? Leave a comment down below about your experiences of solitude, and please feel free to share any thoughts you have as well. If you found this video helpful, be sure to hit the like button and share it with those out there who are still a stranger to the benefits of solitude.
If you like this video and the way we explain the subject, subscribe to our channel. We try to explain complex subjects in simple language and cartoons to support students all around the world in their learning.